This conference was organized in the wake of the current Indian scenario. Now, if you look at the global hunger index, and now the India is one of the unique country which is actually doing very dismal. And in the terms of the hunger index, it's scoring very low, as about 28 in 2016. If you look after another issue, that is the UNO report is saying that India has having about 15.2% of the population is malnourished. In that context, if we look again, how much the post-harvest losses are there in terms of the grains to fresh fruits and vegetables, as well as the dairy products, about 30%. So if we look all these numbers even, I mean, India is also, I think, more than 30-40% population is also the BPL card holders, on whom the government of India is actually giving a lot of subsidies. If we can reduce the post-harvest losses by improving the post-harvest management, that's why this conference was organized. So in that perspective, if we can discuss these issues and we can convey these messages to the government, to the policymakers, that in fact we have to reduce these 30% losses by investing the subsidy portion even to improve these post-harvest technologies to preserve the food and reduce the losses. So in subsequent situation, we can feed these population and we can bring them up from the BPL status to the mainstream population. And that would also lessen the burden of the subsidy on the government part in the long run. So this particular Congress was organized, and several foreign delegates who are the experts in the post-harvest technologies, and they are participating, and today's session are going very efficiently, and there has been various experts from the India as well as from outside and USA and China. They have been participating in this Congress, and today's session actually they are going as we are expecting. And they are going actually even in the greater perspective. If you see this Congress is a very successful on the day one, because we were having a lot of foreign dignitaries as well as the Indian the scientists who have been working as a vice chancellor as well as the other ex vice chancellor and experts, and then the UPCAR, the UP Agriculture Council research. They are having all the collaboration. So we are putting all the people on one platform. So at least the main challenge which is going to be during this Congress as well as after this Congress is how we can translate this message to the farmers. How can translate this message through the policymakers to the farmers. And that's when we are going to make a very good India, which we can say that the shining India, and when we are talking about the development, we can develop all these things. I think we as an academician also, it is not our just responsibility to just have the research and put it in the platform and discuss it, and rather actually it is better responsibility and more responsibility of our policymakers to make a better use of these researches. Which actually, when we are talking, just we shouldn't talk only. I mean, we have to put all these policies in the future programs and implementation in India. If we can do it, even 30-40% of what we make the policies, I think we will be in better position. So I hope that this Congress will serve this purpose. And in the next 2 days, we will have more these kind of discussions, and even on the policies and how to make the post-harvest technologies in the Indian perspective, because there are a lot of technologies which are expensive and which are used at the moment in other foreign countries. However, we can devise with the help of this Congress and discussion in our Indian scenario also. So I hope that this conference will be a great success in the next couple of days.